Hey everybody, Matt Kloskowski here, and I wanted to kind of just give you a quick video on my top five effects. They're effects that I use on every photo. Now, I want to clarify that I don't necessarily use all five of these effects on every photo. That would be like effects overload, but every photo I process is generally going to see one of these effects here, if not a couple of them. Okay, I would love to hear yours. Post them on Facebook and Twitter, and it'd be kind of cool just to see what your top 1, 3, 5, whatever number it is. But anyway, all right, let's hop over to Perfect Effects. First one came out in Perfect Photo Suite 8. It was my absolute favorite. I kind of twisted and pulled and begged everybody at On One to do a tonal contrast type of look, and they really took it a step further with dynamic contrast. And so what's cool about it, I'm going to go ahead and add it. I usually just generally use the natural one. But what's cool about it, this is where it kind of sets itself aside from every other contrast that's out there, is the detail. Because I can add it to small details, which would be all the small stuff here. Medium, which you'll start to see it in the clouds. And then large, which you'll really start to see it in the clouds. So I add this primarily, I do two things with it. I'm really looking to add cloud contrast. If I have mountains, if I have things with a lot of what I consider critical detail, that I want to make sure I add some contrast to, I'd add it to that. Now, in this case, I kind of like the softer feel of the trees and the buildings in front here. So what I would do is just take my masking brush and I would just paint it away from all that stuff. So I'm just going to paint it away from all the detailed stuff because I actually, again, they're not blurry. It's just I like the not quite as contrasty look of all this area because the contrast does tend to add grit to it, and to me, this stuff should be soft. It was a kind of nice sunrise, and I'd want to keep it as soft as I could. So we'll just go ahead and paint it away from there. Now you can see, just affects the sky. What's really nice about this is you can always go down to Protect, and notice how when I start to work on the sky, see how it starts to get darker in some areas, like right there? Well, I can go in here and tell it to protect the shadows. And that'll start to kind of pull it back from some of those darker areas where it's just going to affect the bright areas in the photo. Okay. All right. Let's see here. And by the way, I'm going to cancel out of that one. By the way, I don't just use it on outdoor photos. I use it a lot on people photos as well. Mostly like sports things, things where I want a little bit of a gritty nature to. Same thing, just add natural. And what you'll find here, this is where you can also see some of those medium and large details come out, even some of the small ones. What you'll do again is I'll definitely paint it away from the face because I don't necessarily want to make that more gritty, but you'll also see what it tends to do to background objects, things that are blurry in the photo. We spend a lot of money on lenses to showcase people and sports figures and whatever we have in our photos by maybe shooting it so that the background looks a little blurry. We don't want to draw more attention to it, and that just gives it a weird, funky looking contrast. I'm not even sure what it is, but I'm going to want to paint it away from all the stuff in the background and just to keep the background the way it was. But then we're able to just add some nice contrast to the snowboarder in the pic. And again, you can always reduce the opacity if you want to pull it back. All right, number two. Number two is going to be the vignette. I use the vignette on everything. Just about every photo gets a vignette. This one's simple. Go down here to the vignette section, and Big Softy is probably the one that's going to be my filter of choice. If you click that little thumbs up icon, it sets it into your favorite, so you don't have to go searching for it every time. But that's the one that I use, and what's nice about it is it will darken the edges. All right, you can see that's before, that's after, but there's a little target area here. Click on that, and then I can just drag it around. And I can tell it right where I want that spotlight to be. So I put it right over the people because I wouldn't really want to darken their faces there. If it were a landscape photo, outdoor photo, you know, I'm okay with just darkening the edges. But for the people, we'll probably just want to kind of concentrate the spotlight there and have everything else become dark. There is a white vignette. I would advise against using that. Nothing says 1985 like a white vignette. So let's forget that one. We're going to go with the darker version. All right, so that is the vignette. That's going to get used on every photo. Let's see here. Lens flare. This is another one. I love that. This is a new one that's in Perfect Photo Suite 9. So if you scroll down here, you're going to see there's a lens flare section. And it kind of gives you some previews that you can work off of. I like the upright one. You can see here, it just kind of gives you that really bright lens flare look. And then what I'll do here is just reduce the layer opacity just a little bit. Okay. And then to me, a lot of times, I like it when it concentrates in an area, especially where the sun is. So what I'll do is just grab my masking bug and I will just rotate that around. And then I'll spread it out a little bit. Kind of move it into place here. There we go. Probably bring it down a little bit, but I kind of like it when it's just going to kind of concentrates on one part of the photo. This will be a great photo to add a layer and go add a vignette too. So it'll darken some of the edges, still leave a lot of that lens flare, but it'll also give us a kind of a real nice feel to it. So again, that's before and that's after. Probably pump that one up a little bit. All right, cancel out of that one. My next one here. My next one's going to be something that I use. I actually use this one quite a bit. I use it on people and I use it on landscapes, and that's going to be sunshine. So there's two settings to this one. There is the entire sunshine category, which is right down here, but then there's the sunshine preset. So when I click the sunshine preset, this is why I like it for portraits. For one, it's going to kind of gives you some contrast. So you can see when I turn it off and back on, it kind of deepens a lot of the dark areas here. So that's good. It gives me a little bit of contrast, but it also gives me almost a warm glow to the photo. So it works great for outdoor portraits, even indoor portraits. You know, something, it's got to be typically a brighter type of a photo. Awesome. Also works awesome on landscapes. So sunrise, sunset, even cloudy days tends to work good. But there's some other ones here. Radiance is a good one. Takes out a little bit of the glow, adds a little bit more contrast. But that's going to be another one of the top ones on my list. And then the last one is the actual glow settings here. So we're going to go under the glow section. And when I open that one up, I've got two favorites in here. I've got the Charge More Normal Muted. So it kind of gives you a muted feel to it, but it also gives you a nice glow, almost a desaturated look. Looks really nice. You can pull back the opacity here. And another little trick for you. If you go to your blending options and you tell it like just apply it to the screen blend mode, you don't want to do multiply because that's going to make it darker. But the screen blend mode, take a look. So that's normal. That's screen. So it kind of almost gives them more of a white look than a desaturated look, right? So if you don't want their skin to be totally desaturated, but you want it to be bright, I love that look. And then another one that we have down here is going to be the Hollywood Glow. Those are two of my favorites that I kind of go to all the time. What you're probably going to want to do with Hollywood Glow is reduce the amount of the glow a little bit. To me, it gets a little too soft, especially for portraits, but I don't want to lose some of the key detail in those facial areas. So you can just reduce the amount setting on that one a little bit. But there you go, my five effects. I'd love to hear yours. Share them on Facebook or Twitter. It'd be cool to see what everybody else is. Again, these are my five effects that get used on just about every photo. It's not all five of them, but pretty much at some point or another, any photo that I bring through Perfect Effects is going to have one of those five on it. All right, folks, thanks for watching. My name is Matt Kloskowski, and I'll talk to you again soon.